Man, pick this old ass hoodie up, man. Man, get this shit. Hey, somebody.
Come on.
Hey, somebody get this. Somebody get this fucking European off the floor.
Racism presupposes the ability to control a significant segment of the population economically, politically, and socially by imposing law, covenant, and restriction on their lives. Black people ain't had no capacity to do that.
You're fucking cuckazoid.
Can we be bigoted? Yes. Can we be prejudiced? Yes. Racist? No.
Fucking European of West
No. Look at that shit. Bitch.
You fucking blind-haired blue-eyed devil.
Can we be bigoted? Yes. Can we be prejudiced? Yes. Racist? No.
Man, this lady like a honey, bro. Bro, this lady is like literally a honey, bro. She just got done saying she sucked his dick.
Hey, everybody. This is Roger here. I want to talk to you guys today about a very disturbing video that was just released. It came out about a month ago, but it looks like the individuals who committed the crimes, were recently apprehended. Basically, you can find this video on one of two places, actually three now probably. I found it in a comment section on YouTube from Red Pill. I forget the guy's name, and I'm so sorry. I usually watch him quite a bit. Something Red Pill. And you can also find it on worldstarhiphop.com, and where the individuals who perpetrated the crime or instigated the crime, committed the crime, posted it initially, which is on Facebook. I'm not sure if it's on there anymore. So here's a scenario. A young man by the name of Wesley Norman Martin, 21 or 20 years old, different outlets are showing different ages for him, but I'm going to say 21. He beats an elderly woman while his friend, who is Deondre Jackson, who's 20 years old, filmed it. And Deondre Jackson, I believe, is the one who uploaded it to Facebook as well.
Your eyes are so beautiful.
I know this. Why don't you go be a victim of a drive-by or something?
Well, now, Wesley Norman Martin is also being accused of, or also being charged with, beating a man who attempted to help out this lady. Boy, that was an awesome, that was an awesome punch. Delivered to the criminal. So anyways, with this, both of these guys are facing first-degree felony robbery charges, and the prosecutors right now are seeking a stiffer, harsher penalty than the state, a stiffer sentence than the state currently allows. And I'll talk about a little bit more about that part a little bit later, because I'm not sure if they're asking for a stiffer sentence for the reasons that I see or for other reasons. I do believe they did mention that because of the harsh nature of the way that the crimes were committed to the lady and to the elderly man, that's their reasoning. But there's another one that a lot of people are not talking about that I'm going to be bringing up in this video. It's going to be the core part of my discussion here. So overall, what ended up happening here is, and this all happened before the video, apparently the elderly woman was being groped and all around, and I assume that the individual, Martin, was looking for something to steal. I assume. I don't know. He did end up getting a bottle of liquor from her pocket. And then I think that's about the time that his friend, Deondre Jackson, decided to start filming. And it's during this time that we see close-ups of the elderly woman, and the guy recording is like, oh man, she looks about 100 years old, what's up? And then you also see what's pretty disgusting is a lot of people are crowding around, not doing anything at all. This is your typical society these days. And look, okay, I'm just going to throw this in here because I just thought of it, but Now you don't want, you know, in a situation like this, would the cops be helping? No, not in time. So this is another reason right here for self-defense.
The men and women I've worked with for almost 40 years, we know how to keep America safe.
I think that that would have been a turning factor here, possibly. So anyways, if she was able to defend herself. So anyways, the woman ends up screaming, or not screaming, but like saying very loudly, help me. And everyone is just standing around. Nobody's doing shit. Everybody's watching this happen while this guy is just like, seems, I'm, you know, it is an aggravated robbery. It is an assault type robbery. And I can't say that he beat her up, but he did push her down to the ground. So, I mean, you know, old people can, like the guy said in the video, old people can fracture their hips. Or I think he said that, or I read that in an article. I can't remember. Sorry. But anyways, he was being very aggressive with her, and he was patting her everywhere, and she's just like stunned, like nobody's helping her, probably stunned from the impact and the fact that nobody's helping her at all. The other thing that ends up happening is, you guys can scream. You guys can scream and make your own fucking definitions about this, but there are such things as blacks being racist, as Mexicans being racist, as Asians being racist, as whites being racist, as Filipino being racist, as Puerto Ricans being racist. Everyone across the globe can be racist. I don't give a fuck about any other definition. Oh no, but they can't because they're not oppressed by it. You know what? Fuck your Bernie Sanders definition of if you're a white person, you can't, you don't know what it's like to be poor.
When you're white, you don't know what it's like to be living in a ghetto. You don't know what it's like to be poor. You don't know what it's like to be hassled when you walk down the street or you get dragged out of a car.
You don't know what it's like to be this or that or this or that. He obviously is using that as a tool to fool all you fuckers. And basically what it is everybody in the world, regardless of race, ethnicity, religion, whatever, every single type of person has had a history in each of their demographic lines of being poor, of being rich, of whatever. We all have that blend. Stop making this nonsense. Oh, black people can't be racist. You know, yes. Guess what they were spilling in this whole entire video? They kept calling her the white devil. They kept calling her a fucking cuckazoid. They kept calling her a fucking European. These are their words. These are their words. And you know what? That's racist. It's racist. These two young black men were being racist to this old lady while attacking her. While attacking her and robbing her. So now here's the fun part. There's an old man. And I would guess to venture to say he's 50 to 60 to 70 years old maybe. I believe he's homeless. He looked like he was wearing, you know, a backpack and everything. I don't mean to judge, but man delivered a fucking badass punch to the guy's face, to the perpetrator's face. I love that scene. I will be playing it on repeat in the beginning of the video and at the end of the video, probably somewhere in between. We'll see if I have time. I want to get this out today, so who knows? I'll stop having fun like that. Anyways, this old man sees what's happening. He's the only one that gets up to do something about it.
Damn! What the fuck?
Work. I got to go.
And so he's, you know, he punches the guy. They get in a little scuffle. He lets, Martin ends up letting go of the old lady, but I think the old lady is still being held down by the cameraman at this point. I'm not sure. And then the filming goes on to record the old man and the young and Martin fighting. They wrestle down to the ground. They both get kind of even jabs in, but then Martin ends up getting up somehow and he ends up, kicking the old man in the face twice, a couple of times, and it's a pretty hard watch. So now from here, I don't remember seeing this in the video, but apparently it's alleged that Jackson, the guy who is filming, ends up ripping the woman's shirt off, and then they left shortly thereafter.
I'm your best friend. I even loaned you that dress.
Girl, you can have this little funky dress and these drawers too. I don't know.
Now that's the whole scenario up to this point. Then apparently he uploads it to Facebook, and this is where it gets kind of crazy. This is my main part of the video. The cops know these two young men. They figured out who they were based off of the footage in the station. the train station or whatever they were taking, the bus station, whatever it was. And also, I think the YouTube video helped them recognize who the perps were. They are known to officers. Martin's history is extremely disturbing and disgusting. And again, this is not mentioned anywhere else. I'll go ahead and start mentioning it now. In 2016, Martin had a couple of convictions. I'm not sure if it was two or if it was more. Martin did have 2016 convictions of number one, robbery, and the second one, which you're not going to hear in a lot of outlets, terroristic threats. Now, doesn't this bring another issue to mind here? This issue that brings to my mind anyways is could this scenario right here, even small little scenarios like this, and this is weird, this is just one article that I read brought this up, the other ones didn't. So it just tells me that some other stuff like this is out there, that, you know, current people who are out there committing crimes are probably still doing stuff like this and getting away with it and probably end up leading to more. But wouldn't a terroristic threat have stopped this if we were to have kept that guy in custody for his terroristic threat back in 2016? I'm not sure what, maybe he served a sentence, I don't know. But the sentence should be longer, stiffer, harsher, and the penalty severe. This scenario probably would not have happened. This old lady would not have been threatened. I don't give a shit if anybody's saying, oh, but you know what, she's homeless, she's an alcoholic, she had a bottle in her pocket. Whatever. You know what? Old white people, old black people, old Mexican people, I don't give a shit. Homeless, rich, whatever, you do not deserve something like that. You shouldn't be held subject to something like that. That's a little contradictory to what I normally say. You know, yes, I do personally believe that, I'm calling myself out on my shit right now. I do personally believe that nobody has the right to live. We might have a sovereign right to live. We might have our rights under, laws and efforts and stuff, but it's not a right to live. It's more or less you can live, you can do whatever you want in your life. You have the freedom of choice and doing everything you want. But ultimately, in the end, it's up to you if you want to defend yourself. It's up to you if you want to work hard and be a millionaire. It's up to you if you want to be poor and do nothing and live off the government. All these decisions are up to you, so long as you do them in a legal standard, legal standpoint, and it doesn't affect anybody else outside of normal lawful boundaries. So Wesley Martin made terroristic threats, and he was able to get out and do stuff like this. Now, just imagine how much worse it would have been if this would have gotten more out of hand. You know, if I'm not sure if the kid had weapons or not. I doubt it. You know, maybe he was just homeless or whatever. Just think about that. I mean, that's what I want people to take away from this. This is very little information that's being delivered, and you're not going to hear it. You're just going to hear about the racist parts and the fact that he beat up an old lady. This is the hidden little secret inside this whole thing. This kid was planning a terrorist attack. I don't give a shit if you even just briefly mention it. Something like that should be taken seriously. Is this racism? Yes, it's fucking racism. I don't give a shit what anybody else says about that either. Rebut me if you want to. Tell me why this is not racism. Anybody who wants to go against my definition of what racism is any sort of derogatory feeling and action based off of another person solely because of their color and their background, that is racism. I don't give a shit where it comes from, it's racism. I don't give a shit about ancestral past. If you do it yourself, it's racism. Will this be covered widely? Probably not. I have not seen this covered widely at all. I have only seen it covered in smaller outlets, smaller news outlets, local news outlets, and Red Pill Philosophy, I think is his name. I think I remember it now. Red Pill Philosophy. Cuban, I guess. He's a Cuban guy with always has that big bushy beard. Very good looking, handsome man. anyways, I love the fact that he covers these topics, and I appreciate you putting this out into the limelight, buddy. Great job. I hope this only adds to that, to people thinking about pushing this scenario out for everybody to see the issues going on in the world today. You know, the other last thing that I want to bring up is about family. The family is I'm not sure what these guys' background is. Maybe they come from a horrible family upbringing. I don't know. Maybe their parents are rich. I don't know. Maybe their parents are separated. Maybe they're together. I have no idea. But here's the thing. If it does turn out that these kids were raised in a single family household, especially a single mother, The probability is a lot higher for them statistically to end up in scenarios like this, to end up in very horrible scenarios where they have to, where they basically are assaulting people, killing people, murdering people, going to prisons and stuff. I would say that that drug possession is probably the single biggest thing I do have an issue with in regards to black men being unfairly apprehended for the most part. Now, granted, there's alternate scenarios in there. I recall this one scenario and recently in Florida or Georgia or something, they were having a house party and the cops came over and there was weed in the table or something. And I think the officers had asked everybody what was going on and whose it was, and I think they were resisting the officers' orders. The officers kept giving them chance after chance after chance until finally they said, you know, if you guys aren't willing to cooperate, you know, you're gonna, I'm gonna have to apprehend you guys, all of you guys, or whoever, whatever happens, happens. I'm not sure why, but all the people ended up being all apprehended, you know, and had to, and were booked, whatever. And then everybody made a story out of it saying, oh, you know, because it's the black party, you know, it was just all black kids. They were all arrested by the cops. This is racist. Now, if you read deep into the story, people, it wasn't racist. It's the people didn't, the individuals at the party didn't want to cooperate with the officers. The officers gave them every chance in the world. If I find that story, I'll put it in a link below. Otherwise, do your own research. I'm not your book. to anybody who's going to be, you know, an asshole. I love you guys, though. I love my haters and my likers, so. Anyways, what do you guys think? Is the family a big role in this? Do you think, I'm not sure about the history of these kids, but is the family a big role in this? Is it also the fact that there's a lot of history, or there's a 2016 conviction for Martin regarding his terroristic threats? I mean, that should come into play, and why this guy is out 2 years later in 2018 after a threat that I think should be, even if it's 2 years, you know, I don't know what his sentence was with that, but I think it's very disgusting that he was still out in the streets after that. The crime wasn't harsher. What are you guys' thoughts? Positive, negative? Do you have remorse for this kid, these kids? Do you have remorse for the elderly lady? Do you want them to beat her down more? I don't know. What are you guys' thoughts? I'd really appreciate hearing about it. Other than that, I hope you guys all have a great day. Thanks for watching another one of my videos. Subscribe, rate, thumbs up, thumbs down. I don't give a shit. I'll probably respond to them as much as I can. That's the part I enjoy. Have a great day. Bye.
Baby, I want to sex you up. I want to hose you down. Girl, I got a reputation. I have a reputation to uphold. Now, do I look like I'd be attracted to somebody like that?